St. Francis Healthcare System is known for their legacy of caring for Hawaii's people. They offer a growing spectrum of services and programs to meet the needs of their patients and their families. We're learning more about that today. We welcome in Jerry Correa, CEO of St. Francis Healthcare System. Hello, Jerry. Good morning. Thanks for being here. Tell us about some of the programs and services that you offer.
Thank you. There's a lot of programs. It's hard to start, but going all the way to Makaha, we have Our Lady of Keau that provides services for our homeless community. We feed over 300 homeless people a week. We have spiritual services out there. Working our way back to Eva, we have a 150-room affordable housing for seniors. Across the street from that complex, we have an intergenerational center, which provides adult daycare for about 30 seniors, that provides respite for their caregivers. And attached to that, we have a preschool with services about 50 kids. So we've got Keiki and Kupuna in the same location, which is really unique and very special.
Yes, that is special.
Yeah, and of course our hospice program, which is very core to St. Francis. We service about 250 patients and families on any given day. And we also have our inpatient unit up in Nuuanu for hospice. And perhaps the biggest thing that we're working on right now is revisioning the Liliha campus. We call it our Kupuna Village, geriatric services, a skilled nursing, assisted living, independent living concept. And we just finished with the skilled nursing facility, which has about 119 beds, over half private rooms, so the families can spend more time with their loved ones. On the campus, and this is the part of the revisioning process, we've actually gone back and strategically decided as an organization that we're going to partner with people, knowing that partner with providers, knowing that we can't do everything ourselves, take care of what we're core experts in, like hospice. But in areas where we're not core experts in, like skilled nursing, we'll partner. So I think the success is going to be through the power of partnerships. Mm-hmm. And not just partnering for the sake of partnering, but partnering with key providers that have the similar Franciscan values.
That's a win-win for everybody involved.
It's a win-win, and it takes time to find the right fit. But on the campus, because it was a hospital, there's other services on campus, which makes it unique, not just skilled nursing, assisted living, and independent living. We've got Liberty Dialysis, for example, that serves 300 patients a day. So there's 300 patients a day coming on campus from 7 to 11 at night, 7 days a week. There's a cancer center, the Cancer Center Hawaii, serves about 80 patients a day. We've got pharmacy, we've got labs.
I'm so happy that you're here to explain to us all of the services that you offer, because I was familiar with your hospice care, mm-hmm. but I had no idea you had all of these other programs out mm-hmm. there. Can you tell us real quick, how are you able to provide all of these wonderful services? I know that you're a nonprofit.
Mm-hmm. Correct. I think it's the power of partnerships. Our mission statement is to create healthy communities in the spirit of Christ's healing ministry, but it's about creating healthy communities, and knowing that we can partner, and there's other people that provide those types of services, we're able to do that. So it's the power of partnerships.
One of those partnerships I believe I read about is your partnership with Insurance Solutions.
Correct.
Can you tell us more about that?
Yes, and again, it's insurance is not our core business, but it's really critical to the senior population and the population as a whole. And in vetting and going through different organizations like Insurance Solutions, what's special is, and we go from the top down, how do they treat their employees? How do they treat the people that they serve? It's really awesome.
Mm-hmm. Now, you guys have an event. We're almost out of time, but you guys have an event. Is it this Saturday?
Next Saturday.
Next Saturday.
The 30th.
Okay.
And it's the St. Marianne Walk, and it starts and ends at Kiwalo Basin Park. And proceeds of that walk go to Charity Care, to help with the families in hospice. But what's special about Kewalo Basin is that's where the sisters landed when they came to Hawaii.
Oh.
So it's very special. And we'd like to do more of a partnership with the Howard Hughes Corporation at some point.
Mm-hmm. And that's probably why you have the statue of Marianne Cope there at Kewalo Basin.
It's a 6-foot statue and it's facing out to the ocean, and it's really, really beautiful. And that's where the sisters arrived. So that's what's special about it.
I learned something new. Yeah. Jerry, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.